Hey, welcome back. This is the Director of Change, Benjamin Harvey, from How to Become a Successful Coach and Make a Six-Figure Income. And if you haven't seen the video prior to this one, I suggest you check it out. I went through my PLAYS system, as in the five different types of coaching sessions you can have with a client, and how each one of those different areas sort of mix together to make up a coaching call. In this video, I'd like to cover with you the S, which stands for strategy in the PLAYS system. I'm going to go through a very simple six-step process that will allow you to rapidly develop strategies anytime so that your client can get the results. So if you've got a pen and paper handy, I suggest you pull it out now and start to write this down. First of all, we start with the letter O, and the O stands for outcome. And so the question I want to ask there is what it is that you want. It's quite funny, a lot of people out there don't have a clue what they really want in life. In fact, one of the things I was told that if you ever wanted to get to where you're going, find out exactly what you want and learn how to ask for it. So one of the things you want to get used to asking is, what do you want? What specifically do you want? And make sure you really get that clear. You don't want any of these airy-fairy type goals. You want really specific information that you can really drill down on. The next one is the letter R, which stands for resources. As in, what does your client actually have? What sort of resources they have on hand, ready to go, that's going to assist them to get to where they want to go, and also assist you to assist them to get there to where they want to go. So the second thing is resources. The next one is gaps. And when I look at gaps, I think to myself, what is it that they need to develop? So I look in what they've done, what they've learned, what their education is, what sort of skills they have, and what it is that they actually need to start developing. Next is the F, which stands for first efforts. When I'm thinking of first efforts, I'm asking myself, what's the first thing this client needs to do? As in, what's the first small step that they must do in order to start getting towards their dreams, getting towards their goals? Once I've elicited what that is, then I want to wrap a date and a time around it by which they're going to actually activate or take action on that process. Next is the letter E. And E stands for evaluation. So how do you know if it's actually working? What systems do you have in place to track it, to measure it, to ensure that this strategy is actually being effective? And once you go through that, you'll be able to find out systems of metrics and information and knowledge that will allow you to let yourself know whether or not a strategy is effective. Because one of the things I know about strategies is if they don't work for me, I just let them go and I change them. I'm always open to new ideas, I'm open to systems until I find a strategy that works. And with your clients, it's best to keep reassuring them that everything in life has an ultimate strategy. It really does. And once you own that piece of information, that everything in life does have an ultimate strategy, then it's just a matter of adjusting your strategy until you find one that works. And the final letter is the letter C, which stands for continuity. As in, what do you need to keep this strategy going? So what sort of things can you put in place to get momentum-based activities? One of my business mentors once said to me that there's only two things you need in business: consistency and momentum. So it's very important when you're developing a strategy to have a consistency-based element to it, as in what it is that you need to implement to keep this thing moving. So just to go back through the rapid strategy development system, the O stands for outcomes. What is it that you want? The R stands for resources. What is it that you have? Then the G stands for gaps. What is it that you need to develop? The F stands for first efforts. What's the very first thing you need to get started? The E stands for evaluation, as in how are you going to evaluate it? And the C stands for continuity, as in how are you going to keep it going? I hope this information has been valuable. If you haven't fully registered yet for the course, please do come and check it out. It's a one-day course that'll cover all of my seven trade secrets about how to become a successful coach. And I'm also going to cover how I earned six figures in the very first 12 months of coaching, right after I got my certification, and have been able to increase that significantly over the years I've been doing it. I have had the good fortune of doing over 5,000 one-on-one coaching sessions, and during this one-day event, I'm going to be sharing with you all of the information. I'm going to be lifting up the curtains and telling you every single thing I did to develop my highly successful coaching business. So I look forward to seeing you there, and until we meet again, smile often and do whatever it takes to be your own best friend. See you soon.